did it. Mama Bear's home.
A very special teddy bear is back in the hands of a Vancouver woman after a harrowing adventure. I recently spoke to the woman who turned to the internet to help her find her bear and even got some help from fellow Canadian Ryan Reynolds. This Mama Bear is not just any teddy bear. What is so important about Mama Bear that you had to find her?
My mother passed away from cancer last year, and it's been really difficult, to say the least. This bear was the last present that she gave me before she got really, really sick and the cancer came back.
No matter where you are, a part of me will always be with you forever.
And it sounds like the mother that I grew up with, because the last year and a half when she was dying, she didn't sound like her normal self anymore. She sounded softer, her voice was hoarse, the cancer was really eating away at her body, and this sounds like the goofy, fun-loving mom that I grew up with, and so I cherish it. It's a significant part of my life and definitely my most treasured possession.
How did you lose Mama Bear?
Well, we were moving from one apartment to another, and we had two friends volunteering to help us out. Unfortunately, pretty much as soon as we drive into the alleyway behind the new apartment, our friend calls us and lets us know that he was hit by a van. Immediately, I just ran out of the cabin. I dropped everything that I had. I ran into a car and I went to get him. So in that time, my fiance just immediately started unloading everything from the back of the U-Haul, and I had dropped the bag in front of the U-Haul. When we all just sat down to finally take a breath and just relax, I needed to get box cutters, which I had put in that backpack as well, just to start opening up boxes. And I noticed, hey, where's that bag with the box cutters so that I can start opening up boxes? And immediately my heart just sank. I tore this place apart. Finally, I asked the security of the building to check the security cams in the back alley, and there, plain as day, the thief stealing the bag. I was so devastated. I just went home and I posted on Reddit. And somebody was so touched by the story, they thought that it'd be a good idea to contact a local news station, and luckily I did, because if it wasn't for CBC covering this as a little fluff piece on Saturday morning on the radio, then Ryan Reynolds would never have seen that tweet and this never would have happened. And
how did you feel when Ryan joined on? How important was his help?
Oh, it was so important. Without his exposure boost, I don't think anybody would have cared or picked it up. Deborah, the reporter who first broke the story, felt so bad for me that she tweeted it. And I guess Mr. Reynolds still follows local Vancouver news because he retweeted it. And so my friend had to tell me about it. He said, hey, did you know Ryan Reynolds just tweeted about you? And when I saw it on my phone, I just started sobbing because it's surreal.
The power of just asking. You never know. Just ask. You never know.
Were you a fan of Ryan Reynolds before?
Absolutely. I mean, I'm a Canadian and I live in Vancouver. I think it's mandatory to love Ryan Reynolds, but
it's not up for debate.
It's really not. And it's so funny because my mom was such a jokester, so she loved funny movies. And Deadpool was filmed in Vancouver, and you could actually see like the apartment building that I was living in before in one of the scenes. And my mom's like, look, you're in a movie. And Mom, that's just my apartment building. I'm not in the movie. I really wish I could tell her all about this. I feel like she would have loved it.
If Ryan was watching this right now, what would you say to Ryan? Ryan Reynolds.
Ryan Reynolds, thank you so, so much. I really hope that the reward money helps out the Good Samaritan that returned her. And none of this would have ever happened without your help. So thank you very much. Please come to our wedding.
Yes, I saw you invited him to your wedding. Has he responded yet?
He said yes.
Yes! Ryan's coming to the wedding!
Sounds like something I might do.
He's been DMing me this whole time, asking me for updates and giving me such kind words of encouragement and just telling me that it doesn't, bear or not, my mom will always be in my heart. And it's just been so amazing. And he was the first person I told about the bear. Like, as soon as we got the bear, I DM'd him. I said, Ryan, you need to be the first to know Mama Bear is home.
No matter where you are, a part of me will always be with you forever.
Sounds like such a final kind of, I love you, I'm proud of you, don't worry, no matter where I am, no matter where you are, I'll always be with you. I'll love you to infinity and beyond.
I love you to infinity and beyond.
I've heard it a million times and I still cry every other time that I play it. Now it's not just a reminder of my mom, but it's gonna remind me of how the world came together and how my city had my back for a few days, and that's pretty dang cool.
The internet always wins.